Cotton Electric Cooperative in southwestern part of Oklahoma had estimated 9 days of ice and snow in January 2010, resulted in 340 broken poles, 98 transformers, 3,400 trees damaged. Cotton Electric Cooperative estimated the total cost of the ice storm was $250,000 for replacement of poles, power lines, and labor. Ice was a prime reason for the outages, due to the extreme weight on the power lines alone, stated by Charles Spencer, president of District No. 3 of Cotton Electric. Ice can quadruple its weight on power lines within minutes, bringing down the lines and poles. Also, tree limbs can become a big issue when they are weighted down with ice. They not only become a danger to the environment, to the houses and whatever else is around there, but also to the power lines. In addition, power lines can create many more problems. In Oklahoma and many states, underground power lines have started to become a more popular thing as years go on. Power companies have found that it's a lot safer for the environment. It allows less wrecks, less fires, and it's more cost effective in the long run. This affects both city and country area. The problem with the above ground electricity, it allows more accidents to happen. More power outages. For example, say if someone runs into a power line, it knocks down the power pole, it causes damage to a vehicle, it causes firefighters have to come out, and it just keeps on adding on to what all goes on. Then you have a farmer who has a power line that falls on a cow, maybe near a cow, and the cow doesn't realize what it is, so he goes over and tries to play with it. Well, then he's electrocuted. Then the farmer is out of cow. The cost of moving the power lines, the downside of moving the power lines underground is the extra manpower, the replacement wire, and the equipment on the wear on the equipment. In order for customers to be able to afford it, they need to make the power companies make it more affordable. And as the cost of moving power lines underground for an average person in Cotton County, Cotton Electric area is $6,800 per 12 acres. The electric company required you to put down 50% of it up front, which that would turn off many customers because who has $3,400 to put down? I would see more customers having it done if companies would allow portions of it to be put on your monthly electric bill or work a deal out. Another support of how it is became evidence that underground power lines work. Arla Enos, a farmer in Elgin, Oklahoma, has had his power lines moved underground after losing a show calf, which cost $3,800. He thought at first, well, maybe he'd be able to save the calf because he had noticed that the calf could barely walk. But then he took it to the vet and had noticed that it had broke its back. So therefore, not only had he had lost a calf that was $3,800, and then he had a vet bill. For a while, he had debated on having the Cotton Electric come out and move the power lines underground due to the fact that it would have cost him $5,400 to have it completed. Then he thought about all the cost that he had put into the calf and then the amount that he would have lost whenever he ended up showing it. So therefore, he figured that it would outweigh the cost. So then he had it done. The point of this is that it could be a money saver in the very long run. Yes, it does cost money to put it up front, but you can save more lives. Another example of this is, say, an elderly person that has to have oxygen 24/7. If they don't have the oxygen, they're going to die. Therefore, you have lost somebody else. According to Jerry Renshaw, an agriculture education teacher of Elgin, has stated that it's a common practice to design an underground transmission lines, which would, by means like this, as that it will allow more jobs. In the small town communities, they have experienced the environmental impact since the world is growing in so much areas that people would never have thought that Elgin, Fletcher, and some of these small towns would not be as big, but yet they have all moved, the newer additions have all moved to underground electricity. I asked Mr. Renshaw how he had felt about the underground electricity, and he has stated that it was all worth it. Since moving the wires underground, they have had very few times when electricity had went out. There had been also very few times where, when they did lose electricity, that it stayed out. Most of the time, it came back on within minutes. Also, Mr. Enos had believed that not only would he wouldn't lose any more show calves, or somebody, you know. Or say a tractor would bring into it, then you would start a fire or something else. This goes to show, though, moving the power lines underground, it would save a lot of stress on a lot of people. Think about it, the city folks. They have to have their internet. So that would allow them to have it a lot better. The electricity and the internet would not go out if the wind was blowing too hard. All this could be done if more customers went to their district presidents and talked to them and asked them what they could do to make it more feasible. Even if it means, you know, the individual goes and digs the holes instead of having the company do it. You just have to work it out and see what is best. Another story that I would like to tell would be about my cousin Jennifer Enos, who was killed from a power pole. The only thing, you know, it was kind of partially her fault that she was racing her boyfriend down a gravel road, but at the same time, she had lost control of her vehicle and ran into a power pole, which broke in half and fell on the car and caught on fire, and therefore they were not able to get her out. And that's something else to think about. You know, many lives are lost because of above-ground power poles. To sum it up, overall, the underground power lines might cost a lot more at first, but in the long run, it is cheaper. But also, it might actually help if you have it underground. Because your electricity will less likely to go out, animals will not get hurt, and humans' lives will be more likely to be safe. So I feel this new trend will benefit people in the long run, even if you have to pay quite a bit up front.